and I'm ready for you. Come on, give me your best shot. What can you do, huh? I got all this go.
What you say? That you only meant well, 'cause you did. What you say?
What, you really think I'm gonna do a Dear Sister parody? For crying out loud, I do comic books, not lame Saturday Night Live sketches. Fixer dies of injuries inflicted on him by the grabbers.
Crazy old man! You crazy old man! I love you, Fixer! You're the best there ever was! You're the best! Around! No one's gonna ever keep you down!
Yeah, is that so? So in which of those iterations do I end up a little girl? That would be iteration number 516. It's actually a really interesting twist on everything. Ooh, in iteration number 29, you're a pig! I'm not even kidding either. Google it. Spider-Ham. Oh yeah, they're clearly heading out west, what with New Jersey being directly west of New York, you know. Tom Veitch, the writer, was obviously not much into geography.
Hello, I'm Dr. Linksano. I'm sure many of you are getting ready now to write up your comments and make a little post when the video is finished to let Linkara know that he made a little mistake. At the time Linkara wrote and recorded this review, he was going by a general map of the United States, showing that New Jersey the state is directly below New York the state. Linkara should have gone more specific in his Google map searches with the fact that the villains were going to Hackensack, New Jersey, and they were coming from Manhattan, which according to this map is actually more northwest of the location. So actually, the comic got it right, and they are in fact west at the very least. So we're just going to let you know from all of us here at Atop the Fourth Wall, sorry, we made a mistake.
Okay, what is God waiting for?
For scientists to realize that they should do things on purpose.
On purpose? Hey, how about I test and see how flammable the comic is on purpose? That.
Let's park the bikes and see what the parade's about. Stash a few guns under your coat in case they notice us.
Oh, yeah, your guns are very easily hidden.
Pay no attention to me, fellow citizens!
The problem with scientists is that they're just not very scientific.
She kills Big Q and uses her gun to start decapitating people with bullets. Kamadi and Sleeper get up and grab some guns, shooting into the crowd some more.
You ugly dudes better not try anything funny.
Ugly? I was voted sexiest man alive in the bunker 10 years running! Don't worry, we're cool. Let's ride. Slow ride, baby.
Slow ride! Take it easy!
Mickey the cab driver? No, Mickey the good lord, the proportions on this artwork! Look at the size of her feet. Each one is bigger than her head. Her legs aren't any better, approaching 22 Brides level stilt legs. Say, that reference I just made to 22 Brides reminds me of my review of 22 Brides.
This comic sucks.
There was a deeper meaning I was trying to convey when I reviewed 22 Brides. Namely, that 22 Brides sucked.
Look, Safira Cohen's found a survivor. Look, I'm saying her full name for absolutely no reason.
Mutton Chop Man, with his dying breath, asks them to find Vile John and to tell them that 1,000 Death Slingers from the Night Zone are coming. And then he hands Safira a human finger.
Give him this.
Dude, that's not what's meant when someone says they're offering their hand in marriage. Ooh, let's see how many other jokes I can milk out of this. Man, he really gave her the finger. Boy, that's finger-licking good. I don't think that's what she meant by finger food, man. Zom tells her to get rid of it, but Safira says she's got a feeling they need to hang on to it. So our first plot point revolves around dismembered body parts. Aw, man, I can just tell that this comic's gonna be a feel-good comedy.
Basically, my darling ones, we are here to pass along our new DNA.
Or to put it on a more practical level, to have kitties. Or you are. I'm certainly not.
So, what do you bring to the team, then?
I don't know what I'm here for, but you're here to breed. And let's not forget, Floro's a plant.
There you have it, people. The characters in their own book break down why this entire premise is idiotic.
What's the problem, Kay? As long as we got guns, everything is cool.
Ah, the motto of the 90s.
Dude, that's not true. We need more than guns.
You do?
Chuh, obviously we need a Sega CD, too. I mean, where would we be without that?
Yeah, because that was my problem with Bimbos in Time. If the dinosaur poop at the end had been in color, I would have loved it!
While John orders one of his men named Tanker to open fire on the approaching vehicles, Tanker does so along with his associate, Stinkfoot.
Okay, you gotta imagine that showers are not the highest priority for anybody after the apocalypse, so you have to wonder, how bad is the smell if you've actually earned the name Stinkfoot?
Oh, and he decides to wrap the baby up in his cape and leave her on a roof along with a cell phone calling the police to pick her up. Seems like he could have gone down to the ground and left her with someone there, but what the hell do I know? I'm not the guy who left a baby outside in a heavy rainstorm. Superman returns to the others.
We are so dead.
No, he's just a man!
That's right! I am a man!
Yeah. Hey! Little Poyo figurines. I'm gonna sell these at conventions.
Just a man, yes. A man of steel!
And a very compressed pectorals based on this image.
He asks if he can bring Saphira down too, but she refuses.
You have Carol to give you pleasure. This girl is not permitted.
But Mother, Carol's only a simulation. I can't have children with Carol.
Oh, dear Lord, just try to imagine Kamandi raising kids.
Son, books may be full of thinking, but they won't make your muscles big. Daughter, why don't you have any holes cut out of your pants? What if your mother saw you?
And then we cut to Gotham, where a group of non-Muslim pirates is hijacking an arms shipment. And they're stopped by Batman, who is holding a gun on them. I'd remind you that this is all supposedly taking place in the same universe as The Dark Knight Returns, according to Frank. What did Batman say in that? Something about not using guns?
What happened to no guns?
This is a gun?
Like, maybe you could argue it's not loaded, he's just using it to scare them, but come on! Although, here's a more important question. What is Batman doing in this Superman comic? Couldn't go 5 goddamn minutes without putting Batman in? Hell, even if there was some deep story reason to have him here, it's the final third of the comic! There's less than 20 pages left! We didn't need to have Batman inclusion out of nowhere!
Keep moving, pirates! Or you're all dead!
I know you're the ones keeping DC Comics from arriving in Gotham City! Carol Fane warned me about you! How much is One Face paying you?!
He leads them all onto a boat, I presume he shoved the unconscious ones there too, and has them head off to shore to be picked up by the feds.
It's all so wonderfully quiet, so perfectly Gotham! The constant bleating of my city! The car alarms crying! The police sirens rising! Then falling off, so far away, the lapping waves, the pirates' muffled curses, all of it music to my ears. Specifically, it's a Starland vocal band song. Weird.
He dives into the water to a little motorized engine to escape.
Slap this little darling together in my workshop. She converts sea water straight into electrical power, giving me an ocean of fuel. The concept could have applications. That's if I ever cared to share it.
Na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na, bat dick!
Turns out he wasn't lying to the pirates about them being dead if they didn't move. He set explosives on the boat and destroys it.
That's a lie! I'm free! I'm a free man!
I am a free man!
The hell?
Whoever took my long box better put it the hell back!
Sorry! My bad!
A free man does anything he wants to! I'm gonna stay up
late and watch R-rated movies and eat ice cream for breakfast, and you can't stop me, Mom!